Welcome to today's discussion of Bhakti Sandarbha. We were discussing first Anuccheda. We finished. And we were in. So we have to today start second Anuccheda. Just for reminding you. So I will just speak few things. In the last class, just 5 minutes I will take. We were discussing that first four sandarbhas were speaking about, they are speaking about sambandhi tattvam. So they describe sambandhi tattvam, that means Krishna in the form of Brahman, Paramatma and Bhagavan, and also general tattvam. So that is explained in the Tattva Sandarbha as general tattvam, and Bhagavad Sandarbha it is explained as Bhagavan and Brahman, in Paramatma Sandarbha as Paramatma, and in the Krishna Sandarbha, so Krishna is established as Amshi, cause of all the causes, and he is the cause for the all the avatars. So, and also we discussed definition of Siddha Upadesha, or otherwise Siddha Upadesha, example for Siddha Upadesha. Siddha Upadesha means there is no need to instruct anything specially, but that statement itself will invoke you or provoke you to do action after that immediately hearing. For example, if you take Ejeta Swarga Kamaha, Ejeta Swarga Kamaha. This statement, if you take, what is the meaning of Ejeta Swarga Kamaha? So the one who is desiring heaven, Swarga, he should do Yajna, Ejeta. So here, Ejeta means it is in the Uchilinga, Vidirlinga. It is a statement with the should do, that means the person who is desiring heaven, he should do yajna, should. It's a vidhi, it's a vidhi vakya, it's an injunction. Here, the statements in Vedas, all the injunctions, or we can take it as the upadesha vakyas. Injective sentences are all upadesha vakyas. Injective sentences. Example is Ejeta Swarga Kamaha. It is an injective statement. So it is commanding you, it is ordering you. If you are desiring Swarga, you should do Yajna. Okay? It is instructing us. The statement is instructing us. It's an instructive statement or injective statement. Okay? Purvamimamsakas, just I am saying few more words about this. Purvamimamsakas, they have faith in only injective statements, not the general statements. What is general statement? Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. Brahman is eternal. Brahman is full of knowledge. Brahman is a blissful. Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, this statement is what? It is a just general statement. Is it statement is ordering you anything to do? No. But Ejeta Swarga Kamaha, this statement if you take, then it is ordering you, it is instructing you, you should do Yajna if you desire Swarga. Okay. So, Purvamimamsakas, they have faith in only injective statements, not in the general statements. Ejeta Swarga Kamaha. So, like this, in Karmakanda, you will be seeing so many statements like this. All the Karmakanda statements are in the injective case. So, those statements only they take and they say ది సత్యం జ్ఞానమనంతం బ్రహ్మ దేర్ ఇస్ నో వర్బ్ సచ్ ఏ వర్బ్ విచ్ ఈస్ ఆస్కింగ్ యూ టు డూ యాక్షన్ దేర్ ఇస్ నో యాక్షన్ ఈజ్ ఆస్క్డ్ బై దట్ సెంటెన్స్ సత్యం జ్ఞానం అనంతం బ్రహ్మ బ్రహ్మ ఈజ్ ఎటర్నల్ ఈజ్ నాలెడ్జ్ ఫుల్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్ అండ్ ఫుల్ ఆఫ్ బ్లిస్ ఈజ్ దిస్ స్టేట్మెంట్ ఆర్డరింగ్ ఎనీ వర్క్ ఎనీథింగ్ నో సో దట్స్ వై దే సే దీస్ స్టేట్మెంట్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్ యూజ్లెస్ పూర్వమీమాంసకా సేస్ ది స్టేట్మెంట్స్ ఆర్ యూజ్లెస్ దేర్ ఈజ్ నో యాక్షన్ ఈజ్ రికమెండెడ్ బై దోస్ స్టేట్మెంట్స్ యాక్షన్ ఈజ్ నాట్ గివెన్ బై దోస్ స్టేట్మెంట్స్ యాక్షన్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ గివెన్ టు ద లిజనర్ సో దట్స్ వై దేర్ ఇస్ నో వర్త్ ఇన్ దోస్ స్టేట్మెంట్స్ దే సే దే విల్ టేక్ ఓన్లీ లైక్ ఎజేత స్వర్గకామ దేర్ యాక్షన్ ఈజ్ ప్రిస్క్రైబ్డ్ యూ షుడ్ డూ యజ్ఞ ఫర్ గెటింగ్ స్వర్గ ఓకే సో దట్స్ వై దే బిలీవ్ ఇన్ కర్మ యాక్షన్స్ అండ్ ఎనీ స్టేట్మెంట్ విచ్ ఈజ్ నాట్ ప్రిస్క్రైబింగ్ యాక్షన్ దట్ ఈస్ దే విల్ గివ్ సెకండరీ మీనింగ్ అండ్ దే సే దట్స్ నాట్ హ్యావింగ్ ఎనీ వాల్యూ సో అకార్డింగ్ టు ఆల్ ద ఉపనిషస్ విచ్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో నోన్ యాజ్ వేదాంత దీస్ ఆల్ వేదాంత వాక్యాస్ ఆర్ ది ఉపనిషత్ వాక్యాస్ అకార్డింగ్ టు దెమ్ దే ఆర్ ఆల్ యూజ్లెస్ దే విల్ టేక్ ఓన్లీ కర్మకాండ సెక్షన్ వేర్ దే విల్ ఫైండ్ ఇన్ ఎవ్రీ స్టెప్ దేర్ ఇస్ ఇంజెక్టివ్ స్టేట్మెంట్స్ which indicate or which instruct some work to you. This is the Siddhanta actually, Purvamimamsakas.
So they accept only some statements of Vedas, bro? Some statements only?
Karmakanda is full of like this.
Means they accept only some part of Vedas or like that or?
They accept only Karmakanda.
Okay.
Karmakanda is full of this. But in the Jnanakanda, there are no statements like this. So that's why they don't accept Jnanakanda. They will accept only Karmakanda. That's why we are also known as Karma Mimamsakas, those are all. They are believing in the karma. That is their Siddhanta. So now, why I am saying this? Because according to them, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma is not instructing any action to listener. But we don't take like that. What we are saying, this is Siddha Upadesha. Instruction is there already inside it only. Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, if you hear, what you are understanding, there is one object Brahman which is Vijnanam Anando Brahma, which is full of blissful. And which is eternal, which is permanent, which is full of knowledge. So after hearing this kind of object, you will get naturally, that means tendency. What is your natural tendency? We are always in the sufferings. So we are in this material world with sufferings. So by hearing this statement, we immediately get inspiration to get that. There is no need to instruct. So Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. So Brahma Yajeta. So Brahma Kamo Yajeta. Are they? Whoever is desiring Brahman, they should do something or otherwise some Kuruta, he should do something. There is no need to tell that. Because obviously that statement is instructing us. Like example, that's why we have given one example. Very general example. What is that? There is one poor person. And he came to know in his house, under the ground, there is wealth. So just by hearing there is wealth in underground of my house, then immediately he will, there is no need to instruct him, you dig it and you get it. There is no need to tell. Immediately he will try for that. Similarly, Satyam Jnanam Ananta Brahma also. Okay? So that's why what we are saying, the whole first four chapters, four sandarbhas, they are all describing about the paratattvam. So they are all beautifully describing. That's why they are all what? Four sandarbhas are what we should take as siddha upadesha. What we should take it as? Yes. Are getting or not? Still answers you are giving wrong and saying we should go quickly. You increase the speed. And but answers are not coming. How to increase the speed? Wrong answers all. That's the problem actually. Okay. Okay, first four cantos are, four sandarbhas are siddha upadesha. Okay. But still Shastra, but still you will be finding, of course, after describing Brahman in such a way, then is there any need to describe and teach the avidheya tattva? You should do this, you should do bhakti, you should, is it need? Is there any need? There is no need. Actually, there is no need. But still, because already object is described so nicely and which you want, you have to get that. So by getting that, you'll be having happiness. So is there any need of instructing specially? For buddhiman logon ke liye, no need actually. For the intelligent people, there is no need. But for some people, it is needed. For whom? For who are having the some kind of saithilyam. Saithilyam means some kind of negligence, or otherwise you can say it is opposition. Opposing nature is there. Even after hearing, they are not ready to get it. So then there is a need of teaching. It means you should do bhakti. You are in the suffering. And there are the causes for this suffering. So like this, Shastra is also prescribing the process for us. Is teaching some process to us. There is no need actually, but it is teaching. Just out of mercy to remove our negligence, our saithalyam. So to get the Brahman, so it is doing. Okay. So that's the example is what? For example, what we have, is there any Shastric statement where this process is recommended? You should do bhakti, or you should do something process to get the Brahman or Paratattvam. Is there any example in the Shastra? Is there any example? Who is going to tell? Where we are seeing the instruction? Yes, Bhavagrahi Prabhu.
The sloka bhayas dvitiya bine.
Yes, good. Bhayam dvitiya biniveshitasya dishavatapetasya viparyayo smritihi. Next. Tanmayato buddha abhajetam bhaktyaikesham gurudevatatma. So what this sloka is saying? Where is there is an injective statement? Is there any injective statement in this? Abhajetam means abhajet. Bhajet means it's a vidhi vakya. You should do bhajan. Describing Brahman itself is sufficient, but still to remove our saithalyam towards the bhakti. So this statement is instructing us to do, is teaching, or teaching us to do bhakti, to accept some process. Is there any one more statement? Can you give one more statement like this? Where bhakti is instructed for us as a standard process, or bhakti or any process to get the paratattvam. Is there any? Okay. Okay, thank you. Next anusheda is that one. Kincha. So, okay. Next statement. Next anusheda is also one more example where we are seeing the recommendation of process. Process is instructed for us. You should do this bhajan forgetting paratattvam is said. So I will share the screen. You can also see on the screen. Ramchandra Prabhu, what question you have?
Hare Krishna Prabhu, is that Akama Sar Kamova, is that verse also Akama comes there?
Akama Sar Kamova, Moksha Kamodaradi, Tivrena Bhakti Yogena. Ejeta? Yes. Akamaha means if you want bhakti. Moksha Kama means liberation. And sarva kama means whatever said in the above to this sloka, there are so many things are said. If you want this, you should worship these demigods. So those all things also, if you want, you should worship. You should worship. Wherever should is coming, that is instruction. That is vidhi, vidhirling, and that is the upadesha vakya. That is upadesha vakya. So I sent that file. One second, I didn't download. See, evam svachitte svata eva siddha atma priyortho bhagavan anantaha tam nirvruto niyatartho hita samsara hetu paramascha yatra. Here in this sloka, what is important word? What we are going to say? Bhakti or this standard process is not necessary to get the paratattvam, but still for removing this saithilyam. So this sometimes we are seeing in the shastra, upadesha by the shastra to accept some process to get the paratattva. So for this is the example. So where is the instruction? Which word? Bhajeta. So, bhajeta. Tam bhajeta. One should worship. One should worship. Bhajeta. The translation is, the Lord, who is the very soul, who is most valued, who is real, full of qualities and who is eternal, appears simultaneously in the yogi's heart. The yogi should worship this form. The yogi becomes filled with bliss on perceiving the Lord's form. By this worship, ignorance, the cause of the repeated births, is destroyed. 2.2.6, second canto, second chapter. So, main thing is bhajeta. This is the main point. Is there? Yes. Upadesha vakya, this is. Tikacha, meaning is clear. Meaning of this sloka is clear. Simply what? Bhajeta means should worship. Who should worship? What is a karta? Where is the yogi in this? Satyeva Siddha. Where is Satyeva Siddha? Satyeva Siddha, who is that Satyeva Siddha? Swatayo Siddha is the Karta? No, wrong answer. Who is the Karta? Who is Karta? You all read the second canto, second chapter or not? On-site students, you read, but you are not answering. Who is that? Nirvrutaha niyatarthaha. Nirvrutaha niyatarthaha bhajeta. Nirvrutaha niyatarthaha meaning we will see coming in the tika. Anytime any sloka is given, first you should identify the verb. And then who is the doer of that? That you should do. Karta. Who is that? Nirvrutaha niyatarthaha bhajeta. And then who is the object for the worshipping, activity of worshipping? Increase. Yes, no, here. Okay, this is fine. Okay, was. So, whom he should worship, who is the object? Tam. Nirvrutaha tam bhajeta. Subject, so object and verb. Or otherwise, nirvrutaha bhajeta tam. Okay. Tam kam, who is that? Tam. Who is that? Swachitte swataha siddhaha. Atma priyaha arthaha. Bhagavan Anantaha. Who is that? Whom he should worship? Nirvrutaha should worship whom? Swataha eva swachitte swataha eva siddha. Who is in his heart? Who is existing in his heart by his own? And Atma. Whoever is the Atma? Priyaha. Arthaha. Bhagavan and Anantaha. So by worshipping, what will happen? Yatra means by worshipping. Samsara hetu paramascha. The cause for the samsara, that is what? Avidya. That will be destroyed. Uparamaha. Finished. Okay. This is the meaning. Anyway, main point in this sloka is bhajeta. Here we are seeing the process is instructed for the jiva, but so that's why this is done to remove the saithilya of the jiva. Tika, see the tika. Tada tena kim kartavyam haristu sevyaha. If you want to see commentary, so what are the 5 steps we should remember while seeing the commentary of any sloka? Any acharya, before to write commentary, he does 5 things. What are those? Padachedaha, padarthokti, vigraha vakya, vakya yojanam, akshepa nirasanam. Akshepa? Samadhanam, okay. Aksheva Samadhana. These are the 5 things. First of all, okay, if you want to understand commentary on this sloka, you should know a little bit context also. Otherwise, tada tena kim kartavyam. It is all of a sudden some prasanga is happening. You took out something and you start understanding what you'll get. So this prasanga is like this. Sukadeva Goswami is explaining about the sadhaka. So a self-sufficient sadhaka doesn't need to beg money from the rich people to maintain his bare life, livelihood. That's not good. Yes? Because by doing like this, he'll be wasting his time. So why? Then how he can maintain life? He should not beg anything to maintain bare life also. Then how he can maintain? Then he can maintain. Why? There are the hands are there. What is the need of pillows? there is a 10 directions are there. What is the need of wearing clothes? And when there are the two hands are there, and then what is the use of utensils? Okay. Prabhu, this is there in the first file. First day file I gave. So in that it is there. Savicharj Prabhu. So it is there in the first day of introduction file. Okay. So if your hands are then, what is the need of vessels? No need of vessels. Then someone objected to this sadhaka. Hey. So then how you will eat? How you will eat? Okay, hands are there to vessels. No need of vessels and pillow is not necessary. Hands are there. But how you eat? Then he said, what sadhaka is saying? No need to worry. There are the trees are there. Who can give donation to me? Fruits. And then Purapakshi is asking, opponent, so how you will drink? Then he said, rivers are there. I will drink from the rivers. Then after that, so how you will protect yourself from the hailstorm? So then he said, caves are there. I can stay there. Then Purapakshi is asking, in caves there are the tiger is there. And tigers can eat away. Then how can you live? Then he said, so Lord is there, my heart, he will protect me. So that's why this sloka is coming. Evam swachitte swataha eva siddha. Then that sadhaka is saying, so evam swataha siddha. Lord is existing in the heart of everyone by himself. Nobody is putting. Swataha eva siddha. So, and I will worship that Lord. Then one may ask, oh, if you want to worship Lord, you need to have the paraphernalia. Then there is no need of paraphernalia. There is no need to install deity that is there already in the heart. So like this, he says, Hari, then his continuation, Hari hitu sevyaha ityaha evam viraktaha san. Like this, one should detach from all the material things, tam bhajeta, he should worship him. Evam viraktaha san tam bhajeta. This is the main anvaya. Saha sadhakaha tam bhajeta. Bhajaniyatve hetavaha. Why he should worship him only? What is the reason? Why he should worship Hari who is in the heart? Why not some other person? Because this Hari is existing in everyone's heart by his own will. Swachitte swataha eva siddhaha. So that means he is existing himself. Why like that? Because he is the Atma for everyone. Why he is staying in the heart? Because he is the Atma. He is the Paramatma. For everyone. Ataha eva priya. Since he is Atma to everyone, he is the soul of everyone. For every jiva, he is the soul. Why gopis, they are loving more than their own sons? Why? Because generally we see everyone is loving their sons more than the others. But in the case of gopis, we are seeing when Krishna became their son, they are loving that Krishna more than their sons. In the Brahma Mohan Leela, so what happened? Krishna, so appearing for 1 year as son of gopis and also calf of all the cows. At the time, so we were seeing the love is increased for the gopis and the cows towards the Krishna, who is in the form of their son or their calves. What is the reason? This is the question Parikshit got. And Parikshit is asking, what is the reason? Generally, they like their own son, but they are liking Krishna. Krishna is also son of Yashodamaya. And why they are liking more Yashodamaya's son? They should worship, they should love their own sons. In general practice of any society, everyone loving their own sons, not the neighbor's son. But in here, what is happening? They are loving neighbor's son than their own son. What is the reason? Then what Sukadeva Goswami is answering? Everyone is centered around their self. They like what? Their own self. If they like something means there is, they are ignorantly or somehow they are putting connection, that thing with their self, that's why they are loving. They love country because that is also they are first identifying themselves as the body instead of self, soul, and anything is connected to that body, so is also they are loving. But if they come to know little bit advanced and body is different from the soul, then they start loving what? They are loving the soul, not the body. Then Krishna is the soul to the soul. That means he is the cause of the soul also. That means he is the Paramatma. So that's why which is more lovable, not the soul, because which is the soul to the soul, that is Krishna. That's why they love. The same point here also. That's why Krishna is soul to the soul. That's why everyone love. So Krishna more than their own self also. Okay. So here, since he is the Atma to everyone, that means he is the soul to the soul. So that's why he is more lovable. Priyaha. Priyaha. That means he is more lovable. Priyasya cha seva sukarupa eva. If anyone wants to serve their own dearmost one, that service also will give happiness only. But if you put in such a situation, you have to serve the enemy. So that service give any pleasure? No. So that's why here, what is the point? He said, priyasya cha seva sukarupa eva. So the service to the dearmost one is always blissful only. Arthaha satyaha. That means, and not only that, this Krishna, this soul that is Hari, Atma, is what? One more visheshana is given. What is that? That is arthaha. Arthaha means natu anatmavan mithya. This, see, your mother, father, they are also different species, but they are not permanent. So that's why love towards them is also not permanent, because that body is being destroyed and soul is going to somewhere. Finish. Where is our mother and father? But in the case of Krishna, it is not like that. And he is arthaha. That means he is anatmavan. Natu anatmavan. That means he is not non-matter. He is not mithya. But he is fact. Satyaha means it is a fact. And also what? Bhagavan. He is Bhagavan. That means bhajaniya gunascha. Generally, we love anyone is having this, some special qualities. If someone is so rich, we get automatically respect towards him and also some kind of liking. If someone is very nice, beautiful, then we start liking. If someone is very intelligent, we start liking. That means if anyone is having such opulence, even in the material world, we start liking. But here Krishna is having the Aishwaryasya Samagrasya, in the completeness is there. Having of these things. So that's why he is lovable. And also anantascha. That means one more word is there in the sloka. Anantaha means he is nityaha. He is eternal. Yaha evam bhutaha tam bhajeta. That's why that sadhaka should worship this kind of object. So main thing is what? Should worship. That means here, the process of bhakti is recommended, is taught by scriptures. So this is showing that, yeah, it is the Upadesha Vakyam. Niyatardho nischita swarupaha. And also, niyatardha means, so here, nischita swarupaha tad anubhavanandena nirvrutaha san iti bhaktehe swataha sukhatmakatvam varshitam. That means, everyone nirvrutaha niyatardaha is the visheshanas for whom? These are the visheshanas for the doer, for the sadhaka. That means being fixed in his position. Nirvruta niyatardaha means nischita swarupa. That means being fixed in his swarupa. And what? Niyatardaha. That means nirvrutaha. Nirvrutaha means tad anubhava anandena nirvrutaha san. That means being relishing while worshipping him, that kind of object, one will get the pleasure. Being getting that pleasure, relishing that kind of pleasure, one has to leave everything. That means leave other things. Other than the worshipping Hari, everything, taking pleasure in other things should be left out. Okay. So in this way, that means while you are doing bhakti, you will be relishing bhakti and automatically you will be detached from all other pleasures. Getting pleasure from the material things. And not only that, kimcha, yatra yasmin bhajane sati samsara hetoh avidya uparamo nasho bhavati. So this is the last line's explanation. Yatra means yasmin bhajane. That means in bhajan, by doing bhajan, what will happen? While doing bhajan, what will happen? Samsara hetoho. The cause of the samsara. What is that? That is avidya. Uparamaha means nasho bhavati. That means it is destroyed. Ityesha. Atra chakara tat praptir gneya. So here cha is there. That means chakara is saying, if you worship him, samsara is finished and also you will get that object. That also is possible. Okay. So just you can see in English, the same thing will be there. Tika, you read that. If you have any fine difficulties, so let me know. Next, Anucheda. Okay. Third Anucheda. Yatra yadyapi shravana mananadikam jnana sadhanam api tat sammukhyam eva brahmaksharasya tasya anubhava hetutvat. Brahmakarasya tasya anubhava hetutvat atayeva tat parampara paramparopayogitvat sankhya ashtanga yoga karmanyapi tat samukhyanyeva tatha tesham katamchit bhaktitvam api jayate karmanas tad agnana palana rupat tad ఆజ్ఞాపాలన రూపత్వేన తద్ అర్పితత్వాదినా చ కరణాత్ జ్ఞానాదీనాం చ అన్యత్ర అనాసక్తి హేతుత్వాది ద్వారా భక్తి సచివతయా విధానాత్ తథాపి పూర్వం భక్త్యా భజేత ఇత్యనేన కర్మ జ్ఞానాదికం నాద్రుతం కింతు సాక్షాత్ భక్త్యా శ్రవణ కీర్తనాది లక్షణ ఏవ భజేత ఇతి Uttam. Okay. Till now we are discussing Paramtattvam as Paramtattvam. That can be Brahma, Paramatma, Bhagavan. So, Paramtattvam one should get. That is Hari, that is Krishna, we already established in. We are established in previous Sandarbhas, in the Krishna Sandarbha. There is no doubt in that. But what kind of process we should take up now? Jnana Marga we should take up, Karma Marga we should take up, Ashtanga Yoga, or what? That means Sankhya Yoga, Bhakti Yoga. What yoga we should take to get that Parantattvam, Paratattvam? What process? So now this is the question. So here, what is said here? See the translation of Anusheda number 3. Although Shravana Manana and so on are methods of Jnana and also Samukhya turned towards Paratattva, because they are cause of realization of Paratattva in the form of Brahman, and thus Sankhya, Ashtanga Yoga and Karma are also Samukhya towards Paratattva, being successfully useful in that realization, and in that way somehow their quality of bhakti arises, since karma is okay. Very big sentence. Now we'll break it and understand what he's saying. First is, even though yadyapi shravana mananadikam jnana sadhanam api tat samukhyam eva, shravanam mananam nididhyasanam and so on, they are all also parts of the limbs of the jnana sadhana. They all, what they do, they will turn jivatma towards the paratattva. So that's why tat samukhyam eva, this jnana sadhanam is also brings the samukhyam. Yes? So in what way this jnana sadhanam will achieve Brahman? How this jnana sadhana will give us paratattvam? Sorry. In what form it will give? In the form of Brahman. So that means jnana sadhanam is bringing you paratattvam in the form of Brahman. Is bringing paratattvam in the form of Brahman to you. Okay. Tasyaha anubhava hetutva. That means by practicing jnana, one can experience paratattva in the form of Brahman. Okay, then jnana sadhana will take up. Okay. No? Why? We have to think now. Okay. There are various processes are given. Why? Of course, they are all helping Jivatma to turn towards the Supreme Truth. So, but which one we should take, which process, that we should decide. Okay, that is the main discussion. This is the main discussion. Next, Atayeva Tat Paramparopayogitvat Sankhya Ashtanga Yoga Karmanyapi Tat Samukhyanyeva. Even Sankhya Yoga, Ashtanga and also Karma, they are also Samukhya towards Paratattva. They also. How? They all directly not, but indirectly. Parampara means through indirect way, they are also Samukhya only. Samukhya to Paratattva. Tatha tesham kathamchit bhaktitvam api jayate. So sometimes also we say those as bhakti also. Example, karma is also sometimes known as bhakti. When karma is known as bhakti? When you do some karma and offer that result to the pleasure of the Lord, then that karma is also bhakti. What kind of bhakti that is? Aropa Siddha Bhakti. What bhakti? Aropa Siddha Bhakti. That means karma is also sometimes treated as bhakti. Or also otherwise, karma is also prescribed by the Lord Himself. It is an instruction by the Lord. So you are following the karma in the form of instruction of the Lord. Then that is also following instructions of the Lord is also bhakti. In that way also you can consider it as karmanah tad agna palana rupatvena tad arpitatvadina cha karanat. In this way you can say bhakti, karma also as bhakti. And jnana, Jnana is also is helping the bhakti. Like example, Sangha Siddha Bhakti. There we are, example, we are doing the Swadhyaya, or otherwise we are thinking about the soul. Soul is different from the body. So this kind of, so Jnana you are practicing. So along with the chanting, along with the Mukhya Bhakti. So then their karma, Jnana is helping the main Bhakti, Sravanam Kirtanam. So in this way, here what? Being is accompanying with the Bhakti and also is known as Bhagavad Dharma. Jnana is also treated as Bhagavad Dharma. Where it is said in the 11th canto. It will come in Navayogis. Out of that one is saying this. So Jnana is being the helper of Bhakti is also known as is Samukhyam only. It is also known as Bhagavad Dharma. Bhagavad Dharma. Okay, that means now we have so many things in front of us. Karma is also one kind of Samukhyam. Ashtanga Yoga. Ashtanga Yoga how? So Ashtanga Yoga if you practice, so that Yama, Niyama, Asan, Pranayam, Pratyahar, these are all will help us to meditate on the Lord. So in that way they are also Samukhyam only. Yes, and also Sankhya Yoga is also Samukhyam. Why? Because in Sankhya Yoga what we do? We will try to count the elements, 26 elements, Ishvara, Jiva and 24 elements. By this kind of classification, we will clearly understand the position of Ishvara and Jiva. Sleeping. I know who is that. And he knows. Like Paramatma. Jiva knows and Paramatma knows. No others knows. Okay. Few are sleeping, not one. So don't worry, you are only not one, but you have your friend also who is sleeping with you. Okay. So these are all also Samukhyam only. But tathapi still purvam bhaktya bhajeta. But what is said in the previous two places? That means you see, bhayam ditya abhinivesta, in that, what is said? The jivatma, root cause for the jivatma's miseries is also explained there. Then after that solution, what is given? Tanmaya abhajet. Abhajetam. What is that sloka? That sloka is not an ordinary sloka. That sloka is what it is doing? It is explaining the root cause of Jiva's fear. What is that root cause? That is Isha Dapetasya. That means going away from the Supreme Truth. So this is the cause. And to what is the solution? Then if you want to come out from that fear, what you should do? Abhajetam. He should worship him. So who is the controller of that maya? Okay. And also in the next sloka, Lord is dear to everyone. He is in the heart of the everyone's heart. And he is Bhagavan Anantaha Arthaha. And that kind of Lord, that is ultimate fact. That is the Paratattvam. And how that Paratattvam should be worshipped? By what? By the Jnana? By Ashtanga Yoga? What he said there? By the? Huh? What is said in that? Bhajeta. Worship. You should know he is not said. Or other process is not. Bhajan only is explained there also. Bhajeta. Okay. So that means from these two statements, Swayam Evam Swataha Swachitte Swachitte Swataha Eva Siddha. This Bhayam Ditiya Abhinivesata, from these two slokas. So we are understanding what we should do. Of course, there are so many methods are there which are samukhyam to the paratattva, but out of that what we should accept? Bhaktya bhajet tathapi purvam bhaktya bhajet ityanena karma gnanadikam na adrutam. Karma and jnana are not taken into the consideration, but one should worship that paratattvam by the bhakti. Okay, bhaktya bhajet kintu sakshat bhaktya. Bhakti means what kind of bhakti? Sakshat bhakti shravana kirtanadi lakshana eva bhajet ityuktam. Kintu what? Sakshat bhakti. One should use the sakshat bhakti. One should worship him through the sakshat bhakti only, not the karma and jnana rupa bhakti, not the karma mishra bhakti or the sangha siddha bhakti or the aroba siddha bhakti. No, bhajeta iti uktam. How can you say only karma? That means there is no mix bhakti, only the pure bhakti. That means sakshat bhakti means is a pure bhakti, it's not mix of any other things. Karma gnana anavratam. So how can you say this? Shravana kirtanadi rupa, how he is bringing this here? Can anyone say? Getting or not? It's going outside. Outside the out of box is inside the box. What is there? Actually, in the Bhayam Ditya Abhinivesha, what is said? In the Bhayam Ditya Abhinivesha, what is said? See? Bhaktyaika Bhaktya Ekaya Bhaktya Ekaya Isham Guru Devata Atma Abhaje. Bhaktya is said. By Bhakti is said. Bhakti is Ekaya Bhaktya. Only Bhakti. Ekaya Bhaktya. So only Bhakti. Ekaya means only pure. Only milk means pure milk. Milk means you can put some water and give. That is milk. Only milk means pure. Ekaya bhaktya means only bhakti. No karma gnana mixed. Okay. This, from this you can understand. So that means now if you summarize this, what we are understanding, there are so many methods are there which are sanmukha to the supreme paratattvam, but out of that what we should take? We should take sakshat bhakti. We should take only sakshat bhakti. This we understood till now. Clear? Based upon what sloka we are saying only bhakti? 11:22 11:37 and also 226. Okay, next. Tathaiva sahetukam sri suto upadesho upakramatah eva drishyate. Now you see, if you see line number, any doubts, any questions till now? Okay, ask question. 2 minutes will give time for this.
You was mentioning that how this bhakti is coming to the shravana and kirtana.
Shravana kirtana, shravanam kirtana, kirtana adi lakshana bhakti. We should use. What is the question? Okay, next. Boli Mahaseva Prabhu, tell.
Prabhuji, sanmukha means favorable or what?
Favorable. Turning towards? Unmukha, vimukha, sanmukha. That's sammukhyam. Vaimukhyam, sammukhyam. Vaimukhyam means not having the, not turning towards the Lord. That means doing his own, leaving the Lord and spending life. And Samukhya means turning towards the Lord. Okay. Next. Now, Tathaiva Sahetukam Sri Sutopadesha Karmatah Eva Drishyate. Now you have to establish very thoroughly. Bhakti is only the process we should take up to worship Paratattvam, not other process. That is the now your, that is in your plate now. You should do that. With reasons you should establish. Bhakti is only the process. Bhakti is only the process. That is Sakshat Bhakti is only the process to worship the Lord, Paratattvam. So how do you do? How will you do? You want to do? Yes. So for this, what we are going to take? We are going to take some section of the Srimad Bhagavatam. So, and we are going to establish. What we are going to establish? Bhakti is only the process to worship the Paratattvam. Of course, there are so many methods are there. Karma, Jnana, Ashtanga Yoga, Sankhya Yoga. But Bhakti only we should take up. So that we are going to establish from the Sutopadesha Kramatah Eva Drishyate. Sutta Goswami is starting explaining. From where he is starting? In the Bhagavatam, from where Sutta Goswami is starting his explanation? 1 point, 2 point? Yeah, 6 onwards. From there, Sutta Goswami started speaking. From there, we will start from there and till which sloka we are going? Till 23. Ato vai kavahyaha. We are going to take the section in the Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, second chapter, 6 to 23. This section we are taking to establish what? To establish Bhakti is only the process to worship the Paratattvam, not other process, not the Jnana, not the Yoga, not the Karma. So these are not recommended. This is only is the process we should take up. Okay, you are ready to do that? Yes. Yatha Aha Dvavimshatya. How many slokas are there total? So there are 22. 22 is given what? Dvavimshatya. Dvavimshati means? 22. Okay, next, Savai Ityadina. We'll start from the Savai. Until the end is Ato Vai Kavayaha. Ityanena Granthena. Okay. I will be asking the exams. Exams will be there for the Bhakti Sandarbha also. Establish Bhakti is the only process. Is only the process to worship Paratattva. Then, based upon the teachings of Sutta Goswami. Then you start from here, 6 to 26. Then you will be, not 10 marks, 15 marks. So first we are saying, because it's not a story actually, Bhakti Sandarbha. It is like a practice. You should write exams, you should present your things, and you should speak. Then it will come little bit. So that's why we are also asking, demanding from the students to write exams and to submit assignments, make PPTs, and all these things we'll give. So that the practice will be happening and it will be useful for students. Next, start now. First sloka we are taking. Tatra Sri Bhagavate. Savai pumsam paro dharmo yato bhakti radokshaje aitukya pratihata yayatma suprasidati. What is the meaning? Anushyada number, how much? 3 only, na? Okay. Translation, the supreme dharma for all human beings is that by which bhakti to the Lord arises, which is not motivated by any other results, which cannot be obstructed, and which satisfies the heart completely. This is the first statement. Now you are going to establish, you are going to reset karma, jnana, yoga, ashtanga yoga, everything, sankhya. You are going to establish bhakti is the highest process. To worship Paratattva. See how is Jiva Goswami started and how he is coming. You should remember the flow. So how he categorized and what he said. Everything. So you should make a flow in the PPT. Okay? That flow starting from here. We have a team of devotees who are preparing the PPT. Okay? Every day after class, PPT is prepared. And that is in the Google PPTs. So that anyone in the team, he can edit that. Basic content will be given by our Akshay Hari Prabhu. So he is every day after class adding the slides. And some students who are in the team, they can also access that PPTs and they can add. They can put this some diagrams and they can add. So what will happen next time? So next course we are going to do this through the PPTs also, and we'll make PPT and we'll make a kit. So that we are also translating book, and book will be there, PPTs will be there, question banks will be there, model answers will be there, and so the course will be ready for us. So then we can ask this in every temple to do this. If you provide everything, they will do. Otherwise, if you simply ask, you do Bhakti Sandhar, nobody will do. So you give the everything for them, then they will do. So who is going to help in this, in PPTs? Okay, send the name to my number. So they can just add the comments so that what is happening, that Google PPTs, if you add some comment, so if you add some change, then that comment also, log also is maintained. So then we'll sit and what should be accepted and what should be not accepted, that I will decide. But everyone can work. One is Akshay Hari Prabhu and the second is Nama Sankirtan Prabhu. Anyone is there? Anyone is having time? So sometimes I write diagrams, that also you can draw on the PPT and put it and like this. No, only for bhakti now. Because it's running on. Tattva Sandarbha we'll do slowly. Because already we lost. Now from the start, who is? Namruchi Prabhu. Yes, Nam Sankirtan Prabhu and Namruchi Prabhu are with us. Thank you. Okay. So anyone else? So that you can also get more clarity. You can get more clarity on the things. So okay, two students are going to volunteer. Okay, Akshay Prabhu. Amo going, Prabhu? Okay, you are okay, Prabhuji. I will take your name. But we want competency also. So some people have more skills, so you can utilize those. Okay, 3 devotees. If you have any, if you think in your home, go into your room, so wherever, so you think about this, and if you want to do some help, it's a help for the our previous acharyas, and also for our mission, for our ISKCON society. So we try to bring the proper materials. Books, nowadays nobody is going to read the big, big books having the big, big lines and Sanskrit and this. No, everyone want graphical things. Just chak, chak, chak. So then they will be immediately understanding. Because that is the standard of the society. If you don't update yourself with that, then you cannot push this knowledge to forward. Somehow or other, by hook and crook, this knowledge has to go into the society. That is the goal, actually. Okay, please think about this. And committing means you should do also. Okay, otherwise I will follow up. Come to this, our present discussion. Savaipum samparo dharma. Dharmo yato bhaktira dokshaje ahaitukya prithata yayatma suprasidati. What is saying here? Yat kalu mahapurana arambe prashtam sarvasastrasaram akhila aikantikam shreyo bruhi iti tatrottaram savai ityadi. Why this sloka is said by the Sota Goswami is said here? Why Sota Goswami is saying this sloka? What is the reason? At least all the audience, they have some little understanding on Bhagavatam, expecting that. So we are asking this question. Why Sota Goswami is saying this statement? Because Saunakadi Rishis, they are asking, what is the best beneficial thing for this entire humanity? And what is the essence of all the shastras and which is beneficial to the everyone? What process, what thing, what activity is beneficial for the entire humanity? Then to answer that question, Sota Goswami is saying, Savai Pumsam Paro Dharmo Yato Bhaktira Dakshaje. So that dharma is best dharma for the humanity, which brings bhakti. Okay. Yataha. Dharma adokshaje bhaktihi tat katha shravanadishu ruchir bhavati dharma swanushtitah ityadi vitirekena darshishyamanatvat. So here, what you should understand, here bhakti means what you should take? Tat katha shravanadishu ruchi. Taste in hearing the Krishna katha. Which dharma everyone should accept? What is the ultimate dharma for everyone? What is that? The dharma which brings taste in hearing Krishna katha. Taste means what taste? Anardhini vritti, nishta, after that, ruchi, asakti, bhava. That ruchi, after the anardhini vritti, nishta, then after that ruchi. That ruchi is this? Not that ruchi. Not that stages. What is that? Basic interest of hearing. At least some favorability to hear Krishna katha. That is known as ruchi. Before Shraddha. Even before Shraddha, at least some inclination to hear Krishna katha. Some taste. Okay, let me hear what these sadhus are saying. This kind of thing. This kind of ruchi should bring that activity, that dharma you follow. If that dharma is able to bring this kind of ruchi, then that is best. Paro dharma. Okay. How can you say here bhakti means the basic taste, initial taste of the hearing Krishna katha? Because in the next sloka also it is said, in the coming slokas, dharma swanushtitah pumsam vishvaksena kathasu yaha notpadayeti yedi ratim srama evahi kevalam. That means if any dharma is very nicely practiced, what it should do? it should bring the taste in hearing Krishna Katha. If it is not going to bring that, then that dharma, that practice of dharma is Srama eva hi kevalam. It's a Srama. So from this we are understanding that any dharma you practice that should bring the taste in the hearing Krishna Katha. Yes. Not that rati. Dharma will not bring the that rati, whatever we read in the 14 stages. No? So Adau Shraddha, Sadhu Sangha, Bhajana Kriya, Anardha Nivritti, Nishta, Anardha Nivritti, after that, Ruchi, next, Asakti, Bhav, or Prema. This rati is, bhava is also known as rati, not that one, this here. Okay, not that one. Nishrakshena kathasu yaha notpadayeti, yadi rati means not that rati, that. Dharma will not, following the some varna and ashrama dharma will not bring the rati. No. That will be coming by the continuous chanting of holy name. By the, so, nama, kirtanam only, nama, japa. Chanting holy name only will bring that. Only following dharma will not bring. But here what? This dharma will bring what? Ultimately should bring the basic taste in the hearing of Krishna Katha. We are now analyzing total the teachings of Sota Goswami from 1.2.6 to 22, okay. So till 22. Analyze, now we are analyzing, okay. Next. Iti vakshamana ritya tat santoshartham eva krutaha dharmaha paraha sarvataha sreshtaha na nivritti matra lakshanopi vaimukhya avisheshat. English you can see in the down. I'm not scrolling all the time. This only this line will do and we'll finish. So what else is said? Okay. Everyone should Sanushtitasya dharmasya samsiddhir haritoshanam. Next also is saying, one more sloka is coming. Sanushtitasya dharmasya atah bhumbir didishtreshta varnashram vibhagashaha Sanushtitasya dharmasya samsiddhir haritoshanam. In that sloka, what is said? According to this what? Dharma is done for the pleasure of Hari. So that is the Shrestaha, that is the best one. Dharma is done for the Nishkama Karma Yoga. Dharma, karma, dharma is also known as karma. Karma is done for the Nishkama Karma Yoga also. Some will do the karma in the Bhagavad Gita we are seeing. And that is not meant here. That is not meant here. Here dharma means what? For the pleasure of God. That means savai pumsam paro dharma is only we are explaining. In the savai pumsam paro dharma sloka, dharma means what is that, what kind of dharma, that is, what is the purpose of that dharma? That dharma's purpose is to satisfy Hari, not for the nivritti, not for the nishkama karma yoga. Nishkama karma yoga, if you do dharma for the nishkama karma yoga, what it will bring? If you do dharma for the nishkama karma yoga, it will do what? It will clean the heart and it will simply make you detach from the material pleasure. But is it going to bring the paratattvam? Nishkama karma yoga will bring paratattvam. What it will give? Nishkama, what is the result of nishkama karma yoga? One will understand, I am not body, I am soul. Prabhu, aap log on-site students, you are all transcendental devotees. So several times in every class I say this, but you are always give wrong answer. I don't know what is problem in the simple theory. So Nishkama Karma Yoga will clean the heart and it will just make you to realize yourself as soul. That's all. It is not connecting you to the Paratattvam. So that's why, of course, that means if anyone do activity for the, so for Nishkama Karma Yoga, that is not bringing any Samukhyam. Understand? So that's why that dharma, here dharma means savaipum samparo dharma, dharma means it is not meant for Nishkama Karma Yoga, but for meant for what? Haritoshanam. And here ruchi means what? The basic interest in hearing the Krishna Katha. Bhakti means what here? Sorry, bhakti means ruchi, ruchi in hearing the Krishna Katha. Okay. Thank you very much. Questions? Param Karuna Prabhu, yes.
Yes, Prabhu, Hare Krishna. So, Prabhu, question about Nishkam Karma Yoga. As I told, the Nishkam Karma Yoga put to the platform where, but what I understand is that, Prabhu, Nishkam Karma Yoga, correct me if I'm wrong, leads to the Jnana, and it makes me understand you're not a body, but you're a soul. But it also gives to the some extent the knowledge of Paratattvam as a Brahman. It gives us some Samyukha as a Brahman realization. Am I right or wrong?
No, no. Nishkama Karma Yoga will not connect you to directly to the Paratattva. No. It is only entry door to enter into the Jnana Marga. Nishkama Karma Yoga will purify your heart and you will understand I am soul. But when you associate next with the Jnanis, then you will be understanding the Tat Padartha about the absolute Paratattvam in the form of Brahman. You will read, you will study from the Jnanis. And now you already understood yourself as Tvam. That means Tat Tvamasi. That means Tvam Padartha as soul. And Tat Padartha is also Chit. And Tvam is also Chit. And then you'll do some sadhana to equate both. Then you'll realize Brahman. That is a process happens. Okay, Nishkam.
Okay, Karma. Thank you. Thank you. Yes, Prabhu. I was understanding that Nishkam Karma Yoga directly give to the Tat realization, but you, it's an entry door, and I was not knowing that he has to associate with the Brahman realized soul.
Yeah,
I thought immediately when you get purified, you get Jnani, and once you become Jnani, immediately you get realization of Tat. I was thinking like that.
Yes. Okay, Prabhu. Ashray Gauranga Prabhu, yes.
Hare Krishna Prabhu, in our previous Anucheda,
yes, Prabhu.
If I understood clearly, that there was mentioned that even Sankhya, Yoga, Karmana, Samukhya, bring Samukhya, something was mentioned.
Yes.
So here again, he said, it's Vaimukhya, it's Nishkam Karma, Nishkarma.
Yeah.
But there, it was said Samukhya, yeah, in previous Anucheda.
Somehow we are saying it, they are Samukhya, somehow, but not directly. So because Nishkama Karma Yoga is an entry door for the Jnana, and Jnana will make you, Jnana Sadhana will make you to realize Brahman, Paratattvam as Brahman. So that Nishkama Karma Yoga is also in that way. That means what we said in the previous Anusheda also. So Paramparaya, we said word Parampara. That means not directly, through the connection. It is Samukhya. Now here we are understanding directly it is not bringing the Samukhyam. Nishkam Karma Yoga is not bringing Samukhyam. Okay, Prabhu?
Okay.
Yeah, anything else? Okay. Thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki.